Hello guys, welcome to the OPL assignment video series. Today we'll discuss about the next assignment from group C, that is for implementation of stack and queue using STL, that is standard template library. So we know that in C++ STLs are very much important. They are providing the ready-made classes and libraries with help of we can implement the logics which are very difficult. Okay, so here we can use stack and queue by using stack header file and queue header file. So they are having all the functions defined already, which we just have to call in our function and we have to perform our operation. So first we have to include stack header file and queue header file. Okay, so now in this program we are going to perform push pop operation. So we'll perform those operation with the help of functions, library functions of stack and queue STL. So for that purpose we'll do what? We'll first of all go to main function. In main function, first of all we'll create the object of stack, okay, s, okay, and then create the object of queue. Okay, so we are here now considering only integer input, so because of that I have specified here integer type here, that is integer type of instances we are going to create here only. So this is a stack, this is a queue, okay, which will have only integer type of values or integer type of elements. So after that, here in while, okay, in infinite while loop, I have declared a choice variable, and then I have declared a ELM and ELM1 variable to store the variables, okay, to store the elements of the queue and stack here. Okay, so here I have just shown the stack and queue operation. This string I have shown, I have displayed, and after that four menus has been defined here, that is in the first menu is for inserting, second for deleting, third for displaying, and fourth is for exit. Okay, and finally I ask the user to enter their choice. Okay, enter your choice. So the pop choice variable have taken the input of choice. Okay, and in switch case we'll do the matching of that choice which is entered by user. Okay, so in case one we know that we are performing insert element. Okay, we are performing insertion operation. So we know that stack follows the last in first out principle, means we can do the insertion operation from the top only. Okay, from one side only. Okay, and queue follows the first in first out principle, means where you can insert the elements from back end, that is from the back side, and you can access the element from the front side. Okay, so that we know. So because of that, first of all we'll do what? Here we are having the stack now as, okay, so we'll ask the user. Okay, so we'll ask the user first to enter the element, so enter an element to be inserted. Okay, so this will ask the user. Okay, so with the help of C in, we'll take the input of element now here. So we will declare one variable here, that is element variable, and after that with the help of that we'll take the input of element now. So after that you would push it onto the stack. So with the help of S object we'll call push function and will pass the element variable here. Okay, because we want to insert this element onto the stack. Okay, after that same element we want to push onto the queue. Now see here, queue header file provides the push, same function which is for stack is also used so the same function is used in queue also. So we'll at the same time we'll push the element onto the queue also, and after that I will display element inserted. Okay, so this will display now there. Then after this we'll use handle. Okay, now then break. Okay, this is for insertion only. In second case we want to perform delete operation. Okay, we'll delete the elements from the stack and queue. So at this time we'll first of all we'll do what? In the ELM variable I will return the top of the for stack, okay, top element I will return, and into ELM1 I will return the, here front element of the queue, because here we are going to delete the element. So you know that from the top side the element will be deleted in the stack, and from the front side the element will be deleted in the queue. So both elements will store into two variables in order to display it, what elements are deleted, and after that we'll perform the pop operation on stack with the pop function, and again the pop operation with the pop operation on the queue. Now again see the same function is used for delete operation, for pop operation, that is pop function on queue also. And then I'll display C out element, okay, space, then LM, which is having the element deleted, and then deleted. Okay, so this RD. Okay, so then after that I'll display this LM1, but at this time I will display your stack element, and here I'll display queue element. Okay, so this way we will perform the delete operation. We will call the pop function of both the classes. Okay, then after that in third case we will display the elements. Okay, what are the deleted elements of those? So there is no, we cannot directly access the elements of stack and queue right now, so we have to use functions here. Okay, so we'll go back on top and we'll define a first function, that is display stack of white return type, and I will pass a st stack here. Okay, so st object of stack class here, and inside this I will use while loop, because the stack will have multiple elements, to access those multiple elements we need here loop. So I'll check first for whether the stack is empty or not. If it is not empty, then that time I will display the, I'll access the top element here and I will display it there. Okay, so this will do, and after that with the pop function I'll pop the element, because next if you want to access the next element, then before that you have to pop the top element also, so that next element will become the top of the stack that time. Okay, so this I have done here. Okay, now after this we need here next function, that is just display queue. So the same thing I will do here while loop, and I'll check whether this is empty or not. If it is not empty, that time I will display, okay, I'll display the front element of this queue. Okay, and then with the pop function I'll delete the front also in order to become next element as a front element. Okay, so that we have to do. So two functions has been defined here for display purpose. Okay, then we'll call those functions here. Okay, inside this. Okay, so here we'll call, we'll display C out. Okay, stack elements. Okay, this will display this, and after that we'll call display stack function, and we'll pass the stack here. So what stack we are having? S. Okay, we're having S stack, and then we'll display Q elements. This will display, and then we'll call display Q function and pass Q, that is Q is the variable, Q is the object of Q stack there. Okay, Q class there. Then now after this, okay, here we'll do one thing, that is we'll use slash m, so that will display on new line. Okay, so this way we have done with our program. Our case 4 is for exit of 0, that will terminate the program, and case default is run will be executed on invalid choice or outside the 4, if we enter 5, 6, 7, anything, that time it will be executed. It will display invalid choice there. Okay, and finally return 0. Now we're done with the program. Now we'll compile and run this program. Okay, so program is executing now. So 1 for insert element, so I'll insert 56, element inserted, then again 99, then 1, 33, then 1, 22, and then 1, 67. Okay, so 4 to 5 elements are inserted now. Now we'll display the elements. Now you can see the stack elements and queue elements. So stack follows last in first out and queue follows first in first out. You can see last entered element is 67, that is the top of the stack, and the first entered element, that is 56, that is now front of the queue here. Okay, after that perform the delete operation. Now see, 67, that is top, is deleted, and 56, the front is deleted off queue. Then again I will display the stack and queue elements here. Now you can see there are only 4 elements right now. Okay, and now 4 for exit for terminating the program. Okay, so this way we can do the program, very simple program for implementing the stack and queue by using a standard template library in C++. So if you are having any doubt about this program, please post your doubt and query in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching my video. Bye-bye.